ee-sis, the Integrated Science Investigation of the Sun, is an experiment which looks at energetic particles over a broad range of energies, from tens of thousands of electron volts up to about 100 million electron volts. The ee-sis instrument is based on solid-state detectors. Those are detectors that, when a particle passes through them, energy is deposited, and you can measure that energy, and you can measure that the particle has actually passed through. So there's the solar wind, which is this continuous flow of lower energy particles. And then there are much more sporadic and episodic events like solar flares that spew out great numbers of these much more energetic particles. In our higher energy instrument, we have a whole set of layers of these detectors. And when a particle passes through those layers, it leaves energy in each and every one of those detectors. Those detectors are also segmented in pieces like a pie. And so when a particle comes through from a particular direction, you can tell both the direction the particle came through at, and you can tell the energy and species of that particle by looking at all the different energy depositions. In our lower energy instrument, we also have the same sort of solid-state detectors. But in addition to that, we use an extra trick, which is when the particle passes through a very thin foil, it ejects an electron. We're able to detect that, and that gives us the start timing for the particles. One of the big issues for ee-sis is to understand the difference between solar energetic particles that just come from the sun with a certain energy and those that are energized in interplanetary space as they move outward. By the time they get out to the Earth's orbit, that's all so messed up, mangled up, that it's kind of hard to tell the difference between those. But as we get in closer and closer to the sun, we'll be able to differentiate those two types of sources, which will be really important for understanding the fundamentals of energetic particles in the solar system. By going in close and measuring the detailed distributions of these energetic particles, their energies, directions, and their species, we're going to learn things that we couldn't possibly learn by looking forever from a remote distance. And by understanding our sun in detail, we can understand lots of other stars in much greater detail.